Alrighty, so we do have some exciting news coming out of Hersheypark soon. They are forecasted to be making their biggest announcement in history. It's rumored to be a new entrance and a new roller coaster. The roller coaster is looking like it's going to be about 220 feet tall. So a lot of people are predicting a B&M Hypercoaster. I think it's a pretty safe prediction to make, although it leaves me a little confused. I get it. They have Skyrush, an Intamin Hypercoaster. It's a very different ride experience than a B&M Hypercoaster would provide, but it's still very similar attractions in the end. So I'm very confused as to why Hersheypark went with a B&M Hyper. Again, we don't know for sure if it's going to be a B&M Hyper. I know there's a lot of speculation that Hersheypark could be investing in some sort of different type of coaster, but from what I'm seeing and from what I'm hearing online, a B&M Hyper is definitely the best choice for Hersheypark in terms of what we're seeing from these blueprints. Well, permits, they're not exactly blueprints. So the permits we're seeing, it looks like a B&M Hyper. Now, B&M Hyper seem to be making a comeback in the world stage of coasters nowadays. In fact, it almost seems like everyone wants a B&M Hyper, and every time someone builds a B&M Hyper, they seem to get better. I will say the B&M Hypers being built overseas are definitely outdoing the ones here in North America. Other than Mako, I'm hearing really amazing things about Mako at SeaWorld. So let's hope that if this is a B&M Hyper coming to Hersheypark, it's one of the newer designs that are a lot more unique and thrilling. I would love to see something that has like Behemoth's airtime and Mako's turns, if that makes sense, the curves that that has. Even Shabala, I totally pronounced that wrong, I think. But even something like that with Behemoth's airtime would be fantastic. The image, though, that I'm seeing looks like a very typical B&M layout, minus the three kind of turn slash helixes that it looks to have. It looks like it's going to have that hammerhead that most B&Ms have. It looks like it's going to have two helixes or turns or curves like you see on even Leviathan maybe. So it looks like it might be a breed of B&M Hypers, like a mix of all of them. And maybe Hersheypark asked for that. Maybe they went with what everyone loves about a B&M Hyper at different parks and blended it into one. That would be really smart, but I'm still left a little confused. I don't know. Are you guys as confused as I am? I'm a little shocked that, again, that they went with a B&M Hyper. I was expecting, I know this is far-fetched, but maybe the first T-Rex to come. Hersheypark is known for pushing the limits in a lot of cases with their coasters. In fact, it's definitely one of those parks that I have to hit up next year, and I would have really liked to see either a Giga or a T-Rex or even some sort of RMC of some sort. I would have loved to see another high thrill attraction that we don't typically see at other parks. Again, I jump back to Skyrush. That's one of those rides that are definitely drawing me back to that park next year. Sorry, not back to the park, but to the park next year. And I can't wait to ride. So I would have loved to see another unique attraction coming to Hersheypark instead of another B&M Hyper. Now, this is just one out of two of the parks getting ready to announce attractions for the 2020 season. We're hearing Busch Gardens Williamsburg is also staged to make an exciting announcement, and that too is rumored to be a B&M coaster. Now, could they be adding another B&M Giga coaster to the world lineup of Gigas? I'm not sure, but it's definitely looking like it. So I would have really liked to see kind of Hersheypark do the same thing. With that especially elevated height of 356, I think it was, they had a lot more room to go. 220 for me, it seems like Hersheypark just ordered your typical B&M. I'm definitely open to criticism down below as I'm criticizing a ride that isn't even announced yet. I understand that. We don't know what this coaster is going to be, but at the current moment, it definitely looks like your typical B&M Hyper. But nonetheless, maybe they're trying to draw in, you know, a bigger crowd. And sometimes as enthusiasts, we do kind of overlook the bigger picture. And B&M coasters like Behemoth and Mako and the ones at Carowinds and Kings Island, like Diamondback, are very popular amongst the general public, but not always popular amongst enthusiasts. And sometimes we forget that these coasters aren't designed for us. They're designed for the general public, and they're going to be extremely popular regardless. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm excited for Hersheypark's announcement, regardless of what it is. It could be a kiddie coaster. A coaster is a coaster, and it's becoming a much better world for coaster lineups in 2019, and 2020 is looking even better. So I'm excited. Hopefully you guys are excited. Give the video a like, subscribe if you haven't, and share this video for others to enjoy. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.